here by going through the payment methods here, and we can see by default cards are turned on, and also Apple Pay and Google Pay is also turned on here. And one more important aspect here I would like to cover is, like, if you want to make a payment, even that is a test payment here through Google Pay, in your mobile Google Pay should be installed and a valid card is to be added in that particular Google Pay account. So you cannot just install the Google Pay without any user, without any real-time card added to that particular account. In this vlog, we are going to see the implementation of Stripe payment gateway in your Flutter application. So we are going to see in detail implementation right from the basic step, that is creating an account in Stripe. So why Stripe? Stripe provides you a very good infrastructure for implementing a payment gateway in both mobile applications and website, and provides the developer a very good suite such that it will be very much easy for developers to get started with integrating Stripe. And now comes the important aspect, like, what is the pricing of the Stripe here. So let's go to the pricing category here and try to see how does Stripe charge when we are going to make use of their payment gateway. As it says, like, pay as you go. So there is no monthly charges here, as in how you get the payments, and based on the number of payments you will be charged accordingly. And also it provides you a real-time reporting such that you will get a complete information on the payment you received, like the user details and also the country and all these things from where you got the payment. And so why I have specified countries here is, like, Stripe is available in like 40 plus countries here, and in future they may expand in other countries as well. So this is a basic introduction, like, why we need to choose Stripe payment gateway over the other payment gateways available. So now let's try to create an account here. And why we have started from the account creation? Because here, while creating an account, you need to specify your country. For example, you are a resident of India and you have created an account by selecting any other country, then it might be an issue for you later on, because you cannot change the country once your account gets activated. Then you need to create one more account based on the country you are residing in. So this is my email address, and I have specified my email address here and also my name. And here by default India is been selected, so I'm just going to continue with this particular country here. So try to specify a secure password here. For the tutorial purpose, I have just specified a normal password. And now we have logged into our dashboard here. And you can clearly see the welcome message is like, welcome to Stripe India and activating your Stripe India beta invite. And we'll be getting an email to our registered email address, and we need to activate our account from there. So here we have got a verification message from the Stripe here, and now I'm going to activate our Stripe account. So it is again asking us the password. And once we enter the password, our account gets activated. So now it is asking us to activate payments or skip for now. So let's try to tap on activate payments. And here you can go through these particular aspects when you want to integrate Stripe for your business. So these are all the details you need to fill here. And business location. So as I have said earlier, right, you need to select your business location, and here I have selected India as my business location. And also you need to specify your type of the business here. So for now I'm just specifying individual, because for the tutorial purpose I'm doing this particular Stripe integration. And let's tap on continue. So select your business type according to your business, and also you need to specify all these details. And for now I'm just going to skip all these things. And now the next step is, you need to specify your personal details, like legal name, email address. Email address is being populated, the email address which you have provided at the registration time, and date of birth, home address, phone number, permanent account number, that is PAN number, because I have specified my country to be India. And the next steps are, you need to specify the business details here and also your public details. So I'm going to fill all these things offline. Here you need to also specify your bank account. So for which account you need to receive these payments. You need to specify properly all these things, and then you need to tap on the continue button. And the further step is like securing your account. How you want to secure your account? So you can use an authenticator app. So this app is available for you in Play Store and App Store. You can just download this app on your mobile, and whenever you are trying to log into your Stripe, you need to make use of this particular app and try to authenticate your login. And here, add a security key and use SMS. These are the other two options available for you. So based on your requirement, you can select these options as well. And the final step is review and finish. So whenever you have filled all the forms required here, and it will be shown up here, and you need to agree and submit if all the details are correct for your account to be created. So these are all your personal fields. So fill them according to your business requirement. And now I'm just continuing to the dashboard here, and you can clearly see I have not activated my account. So here in this particular tab, like payments here, you will be trying to see all the payments made by you here. So as we proceed to the tutorial, we will be seeing the payments which we made in this particular tab. And the remaining tabs are like balances, customer, products. All these things we will be seeing according to the tutorial flow. And the most important aspect here under the developers is like you will be having your API keys. And before going to this particular tab here, you can see test mode is activated. So here we are currently running in our test mode, and you need to activate your account to access live data. So as and how we start development, we will be starting with the test mode itself. So here by default test mode is provided for us, and once you activate your account, you will be also provided with the live data. That is, you will have the access for the production level payment gateway. So here you can see we have got the publishable key and also a secret key. So these two play an important role in your integration. So you can find these two keys in the API keys over here. So once I tap on this particular API keys here, you can find your publishable key and the secret key. So if you want to have the access to the secret key, you need to tap on the reveal test key here, and it will be providing you the secret key. And based on the account configuration, it will also ask you to specify your password to view the secret key. But here I have not added any restrictions to my account because I have just created it. And these are the other options we are having, like webhooks. So initially we have discussed like how we can implement Stripe on different platforms like mobile and web. So these will use when you are trying to make use of and trying to listen the events, like on the successful payment, you want to perform some task in your database, like you need to store the user details. So these are all the things we need to use at that particular time. And here events and logs. So as we have just created a new account, we don't have anything in these particular sections as of now. And this is our home screen. We are back to our home screen. And as we have discussed in the initial level, like we will be having a detailed reporting here. And today you can see we just don't have any details here, like we don't have any balance or payouts because this is a brand new account. And once you get started with using this particular Stripe account, you'll be getting to know all your account details, like how much balance is there in your account and what are all the transactions done in your account. And here you can add your business account now. So you can add multiple accounts here. So you are having multiple business, then you can just make use of here and add those multiple business and try to manage them from the same console here. And now let's go to the settings tab available here, and you can see the payment methods now. So what are all the payment methods you want to integrate in your application? So the basic payment is like card. So that is, you can make use of a debit card or credit card. And nowadays there is a trend like you need to make use of Google Pay and Apple Pay, and also you can implement them here by going through the payment methods here. And we can see by default cards are turned on, and also Apple Pay and Google Pay is also turned on here. And one more important aspect here I would like to cover is, like, if you want to make a payment, even that is a test payment here through Google Pay, in your mobile Google Pay should be installed and a valid card is to be added in that particular Google Pay account. So you cannot just install Google Pay without any user, without any real-time card added to that particular account. And also I will be clearly showing you in further tutorials, like how to activate test suite for your Google Pay testing here. So in development, in test mode, even you can test the Google Pay and make a transaction in your application. So we will be going to see them in our further coming tutorials. And this is about the Apple Pay here. And for the Apple Pay, you need to add some certificate such that Apple Pay will be available for you to integrate in your application and website as well here. And you need to have an iPhone or a MacBook for testing this particular Apple Pay here. So these are the requirements for Google Pay and Apple Pay. And cards here, we can make use of the test cards available here. So there is no any specific requirement for the cards here. You can just enter the card number and try to make a payment, which we are going to see in our next tutorial. So this is it for this particular tutorial on Stripe account creation. And I hope this is clear for you. And from our next tutorials, we'll be going to see how to integrate Stripe in our Flutter application. And also we'll try to make a payment, and I will be showing you in the payments tab over here. So this is it for this particular tutorial. For more interesting tutorials, and if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.